Hello, my name is Janine, and in this video, I'm going to teach you about Orion the Hunter, a very famous constellation. And I'd like to teach you about how you can find it in the sky, what the bright stars are, and the deep space objects you can find within the constellation. Before we take a look at what Orion looks like in the sky, let's examine the legend behind Orion. Its bright stars have been identified for thousands of years. It has been mentioned in Homer's Odyssey text, and even in the present day, many have seen this group of stars simply if they go into the movie theater, because this is a logo of a very famous movie production company. The ancient Arabs were said to be the first to recognize this constellation, but the most famous legends are derived from Greek and Roman legends. Orion's current name is derived from Greek mythology, in which he was depicted as a gigantic, supernaturally strong hunter of ancient times. Probably the most famous myth of Orion out there is about Gaia's rage at Orion. He threatened to kill every animal on the planet, and she is protector of the Earth. So she was very angry at Orion, and she released a deadly scorpion upon him. Orion ended up puncturing his heel, and the scorpion killed him. And it is said this is the reason that the constellations Scorpius and Orion are never seen at the sky in the same time. So, if you take a look at a star map right here, and here is Orion in the winter sky, this is where Scorpio is. So, you can never see them in the sky at the same time. And Orion has many myths and legends that surround it that go back thousands of years, and there's way too many to recount in this video. But it's fascinating that many, many cultures did see some form of a human in the pattern of the stars. Now let's take a quick look at the pattern of Orion. So here is a picture of Orion, and hopefully when you look at it, you can notice some patterns or bright stars or maybe even some fuzzy objects in the photograph. If we want to take a look at the pattern of what Orion looks like, here is the shape that he traces out in the sky. Now remember with constellations as well, when we're talking about constellations, it's not just all the bright stars, but rather a huge area of the sky that is designated as a constellation, and everything within these border lines is considered to be part of the constellation of Orion. So, for example, this area of the sky would be part of the constellation of Orion, and this star, and so on and so forth. But we can really just observe the bright stars in the sky. Here's another picture of Orion, and hopefully, as you look at it a second time, you can still see the pattern of the belt stars right here. And here's one of the shoulder stars, another shoulder star. Down here, this would be the legs or possibly knees of Orion, and here's the other side. And this famous object right here is known as Orion's Nebula. We'll talk about that in a little bit. But this is supposed to represent his sword. Now, out of all the constellations in the winter sky, Orion is definitely the first one you want to be able to identify. And that's because if you can find Orion, you can find every other constellation that surrounds it within the winter sky. For example, if you take the belt stars and follow an imaginary line down, this arrow will point you down to Sirius, which is the brightest star in the night sky in the constellation called Canis Major, which is known as the Great Dog. And if you take the belt stars and follow upwards, it will lead you to Taurus and point you to the red star called Aldebaran. And moving forward, if you use the shoulder stars moving across Orion, it will point to Procyon, which is another bright star in the constellation Canis Minor. And furthermore, if you go from Rigel to Betelgeuse, this will lead you up to Gemini, right up in this area. You can't see all these constellations, I'm just trying to show you where it's pointing to. And then finally, if you do the other side from the knee up to the shoulder, it will point to Auriga, the charioteer. Remember that if you can find Orion, you can find all the other constellations within the winter sky. As we take a look at this large scale view of the sky, again, take a look at this and see if you can find Orion. And now I want to show you how you use Orion to find the rest of the constellations in the sky. So here is Orion. Hopefully, you're seeing the belt stars. And this will lead you down to Sirius and Canis Major. You can also use the belt stars to point up to Aldebaran, which is this bright star in Taurus, the Bull. And then you can use the shoulder stars to point you to Procyon. Next, you can use the knee all the way up to shoulder, and this points you up to Gemini, which is this constellation here. And then finally, on the other side of Orion, it will point you up to Auriga, which is this pentagon-looking shaped constellation. If we take all that away again and we want to look at what these individual constellations look like, here is where they sit in the sky. So here is Orion, Canis Major, Minor, Gemini, Auriga, and then Taurus will be right here. And you can even see a portion of the constellation called Cancer. Orion also has some really cool bright stars within this constellation. So let's take a look at what these look like. The bright stars that are named within this constellation, we have Betelgeuse right here. Some people often pronounce this as Betelgeuse, but it's actually Betelgeuse. And this is a bright red star. It's a red giant star towards the end of its life, and it's about 310 light years away. So it's pretty close to the Earth in relation to many other things. The other bright star right here is Rigel, and Rigel is a whitish blue star, and it's very, very large. It's a super giant star towards the end of its life, and it's very far away, 900 light years away. But, and again, in comparison to other things, that is relatively close. And then we have Bellatrix right here, and this is another bluish colored star, and it is 250 light years away. The other stars I'd like to quickly talk about in Orion are the belt stars, and if we take a closer look at these stars, we have Alnitak, which is 1100 light years away, then Alnilam, which is 1200 light years away, and then Mintaka, and this one is 1400 light years away. So they all have general meanings that surround the word belt or string of pearls in Arabic. And then what's important to know about the three belt stars is right here. You have the Great Orion Nebula, and you also have the Horsehead Nebula right here. So, if you have a set of binoculars, this is a really great area to look at. So, if we were to zoom in on this area right here, you could see the Horsehead Nebula. This is such a cool picture. And here, this is a colored version to help you see all the little details within the cloud of gas and dust. But this is what it would look like through a telescope. So, again, very cool celestial object. And if we bounce back here, looking at the Great Orion Nebula, this is what this looks like. And this is a colored version, again, to help bring out the features within Orion, but it's also known as Messier Object 42 and 43. So this is the Great Orion Nebula, and it's really a stellar nursery where the stars are being born. So, just to recap, Orion the Hunter, it's a constellation that can be seen in the winter months. It's seasonal, so it's not one we see all year round, only during the winter. And the best way to look for it are to find the three belt stars right here. We also have Betelgeuse and Rigel and Bellatrix right here. And the celestial objects you can take a look at are the Orion Nebula, the Great Orion Nebula right here. And then the Horsehead Nebula is right near that first belt star. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoy this video teaching you a little bit about the constellation of Orion.